You're watching Money on Main Street. I'm Giovanna Dierpik. In today's Eye on the Island, who doesn't think working with animals would be a cool career? But what's really involved? And how do you bounce back when things are tough? Pet photographer Richie Schwartz has important lessons for all kinds of businesses. Max Fields is getting ready for his big moment in front of the camera. While Max gets primed and primed for pictures, the man behind the camera, Richie Schwartz, gets his tools and toys ready for work.
I've got the old rubber chicken. We have the bear. I've got the old bicycle horn.
Schwartz has developed a bag of tricks to get the best shot out of the pets he photographs. After photographing more than 75,000 pets over 36 years, he's figured out what works and what doesn't.
I spend money on cheese just for the dogs. Instead of using the store-bought treats.
Many of Schwartz's relatives became attorneys, but Schwartz preferred to work with animals and pictures.
Hey, old man. Remember me?
And I would take pictures of their dogs after the grooming, and we decorated the waiting room in this animal hospital and put up the pictures. And people started to say, hey, that's pretty good. Can I buy it?
So Schwartz thought,
they're buying my pictures. Maybe that's what I should be doing.
So he looked in the newspaper and spotted an ad for a photographer where they provided training. He applied for and landed the job at the age of 29. That training provided one of many lessons.
I don't think that you should be living on a dream and saying, oh, I have this dream, I'd love to do it, looks like fun, and not take some concrete steps to educate yourself on how to do it.
For photography, he recommends
apprenticeship, working for somebody else, taking some classes, doing some workshops, and putting in the blood, sweat, and tears to get yourself some experience before you hang out a shingle that says photographer.
Just take half a step back without letting go.
And don't be fooled. While it's fun to take pictures, Schwartz says that's the least of it.
10% taking pictures, 10% editing, and 80% running the business.
That means
there's advertising, there's promotion, there's networking, there's making sure your insurance is paid and you have all the proper licenses and the rent is paid.
Schwartz says one of his biggest lessons came from one of his worst mistakes. He had a contract to do pet photographs for 81 stores of a big chain. He did it from 2002 through 2008. And then,
at the end of 2009, they decided they were going to try something different, and they told me that they no longer need my services. So they gave me a one-month notice.
It was catastrophic for his business.
So in 30 days, 95% of my income was gone. Now I have a studio that I rent. I have people that I employ. I have production assistant, an office manager, other photographers. Like that, we were all out of work, basically.
That just led to another costly mistake.
Trying to keep everybody on the payroll without the income that I was used to. And spent a lot of money trying to be nice.
So around the age of 55, Schwartz had to pick himself back up, start over, and hustle. He remembered something he read from a well-known billionaire, Donald Trump.
Now, I'm not going to talk about his politics. He's not my cup of tea, but as a business person, I really admire what he's done. The one thing that I read one time that stuck with me to this day, he said, as long as you're going to think big. And I said, well, that's really simple, but the concept is amazing.
It provided Schwartz with the inspiration to partner with other companies and go to them. On this particular day, he partnered with Joe Mark Grooming to provide pet pictures at a $10 sitting fee plus the picture package, which starts at $25. His average client spends about $150. Sessions at his studio are pricier.
Go to where the pets are. So instead of having one location, which is my studio in West Hempstead, which I do have, and having the client base in the proximity, I now, in partnering with other stores, I'm able to expand my base of customers tenfold, 20-fold, 30-fold.
He says it builds their client base and builds his client base. And while Schwartz never knows if the pet of the moment is going to be a freshly blown out Max, bulldog siblings like Grimsley and Pebbles, this cat that does commercials named Tigger, or Diego the Chihuahua, 6'3" Schwartz is always thinking of making his miniature clients happy.
I'm thinking that I hope they're going to kiss me and they're going to like me as much as I like them. It's just love. And, you know, there's just nothing between me and the animals.
Look, you're so cute.